solving our common problem. I speak at this victory dinner not only as the head of the Democratic Party, but as the representative of all Americans who have faith in political and economic and social democracy in every part of the land. The Democratic Party, once a minority party, is today the majority party by the greatest majority any party ever had. And it will remain the majority party so long as it continues to justify them. And whether we shall celebrate in 1938 and in 1940 and in 1944 as we celebrate tonight will deservedly depend upon whether the party continues on its course and solves these problems. And if I have aught to say about it, it will continue on its course and it will solve these problems. We remember that we gave warning last November that we'd only just begun to fight. Did some people really believe that we didn't mean it? Well, I meant it, and you meant it. 1941, and I could feel just what horrid thoughts my friend was thinking. And so in order to relieve his anxiety, I went on to say, my great ambition on January 20th, 1941, is to turn over the desk and chair in the White House, this desk and chair, to my successor, whoever he may be, with the assurance that I am at the same time turning over to him as president a nation intact, a nation at peace, a nation prosperous, a nation clear in its knowledge of what power it has to serve its own citizens, a nation that is in a position to use those powers to the full in order to move forward steadily to meet the modern needs of humanity, a nation which has thus proved that the democratic form and methods of national government can and will succeed. Tragic war between the states. But economic freedom for the wage earner and the farmer and the small businessman will not wait like emancipation for 40 years. It will not wait for 4 years. It will not wait at all. Democracy in many lands has failed for the time being to meet human needs. People have become so fed up with futile debate and party bickering over methods that they have been willing to surrender democratic processes and principles in order to get things done. They have forgotten the lessons of history that the ultimate failures of dictatorships cost humanity far more than any temporary failures of democracy. And in the United States, democracy has not yet failed and does not need to fail. The Agricultural Adjustment Act testified to our full faith and confidence that the very nature of our major crops of America makes them articles of commerce between the states. The AAA testified also to our full faith and confidence that the preservation of sound agriculture is essential to the general welfare, that the Congress of the United States had full constitutional authority to solve the national economic problems of the nation's agriculture. And by overwhelming votes, the Congress thought so too. You know who assumed the power to veto and did veto that program. In the campaign of 1950, things we have only just begun to fight. And their families enough to live on decent. The railroad was finally outlawed as the child labor statute had been outlawed 20 years before. Cannot afford either individually or as a party to postpone or run away from that fight on the advice of defeatist lawyers. Let them try that advice on sweating men piling sandbags on the levees in Louisville and Cairo and Memphis. With any reasonable certainty that what we do will not be nullified as unconstitutional. The language of the decisions already rendered, and the widespread refusal to obey law, incited by the attitude of the courts, create doubts and difficulties for almost everything else for which we have promised to fight. Help for the crippled, for the blind, for the mothers, insurance for the unemployed, security for the aged, protection of the consumer against monopoly and speculation, protection of the investor, the wiping out of slums, cheaper electricity for the homes and farms of America. And in this fight, as the lawyers themselves say, time is of the essence. In three elections during the past 5 years, great majorities have approved what we are trying to do. To me, and I am sure to you, those majorities mean that the people themselves realize the increasing urgency that we meet their needs now. Every delay,